Coming up, I'm going to show you how to upgrade your Ubuntu 16.04 LTS Server Edition to Ubuntu 18.04 LTS Server Edition. Every 2 years, Ubuntu releases an LTS or long-term support edition of their operating system. The LTS editions are supported for up to 5 years after their release. This is beneficial as Ubuntu OS has an update every 6 months, which occurs in April and October. The final version of Ubuntu 18.04 was released on April 28, 2018. Today I'm going to upgrade my development server to the 18.04 version. The commands that are used in this video will be available in the description below. It will also be available as a shell script from my GitHub repository. The link to the repository will also be in the description below. To begin, you'll need to open a terminal window. And since I'm running this from a virtual machine, I am going to use the terminal window that is connected to that virtual machine. And so the first command I'm going to run is lsb underscore release dash a. And that will show that I am running Ubuntu and that I am running the 16.04 release of the operating system. Next, I'm going to upgrade the OS and its packages to the latest version to make sure that we have any last minute changes that may need to be done are also pulled in. So to do that, I'm going to run sudo apt-get update and then sudo apt-get upgrade as one command with the dash y option after upgrade. And if prompted, enter your password for sudo. And now that that has completed, you want to make sure that you're also using a configuration management system such as Git or even Subversion. That way, if you have an issue with your configuration files, you can restore those files back to the system and then reboot your system. If you don't have those configuration files, you'll end up having to reinstall the OS from scratch and set up everything else from scratch. I have another tutorial that shows you how to set up the etc directory as well as any other directory with Git or any other versioning software. To continue on, the next you'll need to run the upgrade command, which is sudo do dash release dash upgrade. And it will go and check for the latest Ubuntu release that's available to be downloaded, and then it will download that version. You also make sure that you have a stable internet connection. If you don't have a stable internet connection, the install or upgrade will fail. This will take some time to complete. If there are any conflicts with the configuration files that you have in place, the system will manually prompt you for how to resolve those. After the update has completed, you'll need to restart your computer if it does not automatically restart. Once it comes back online, check that you have the latest OS installed by rerunning the command. So I have some additional packages installed on my system. In particular, webmin is one of those additional packages that is finding in the source list, and it won't continue unless I give it permission to do so since it's asking for confirmation. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit enter so they can continue on. As you see here, I've reached a prompt where it has checked all the packages that are currently installed on our system and the new packages that will need to be installed as part of the upgrade. As you see, it says there are three packages that are no longer supported, so those will probably be removed. There are five packages that are clearly going to be removed, 147 packages that will be installed, and 555 packages that will be upgraded. There'll be a download total of 408 megabytes. This download will take about 51 minutes based on a 1 megabyte DSL connection and about 5 hours with a 56K modem. I currently have a 100 megabit connection, so based upon this calculation that it has already done, that should take approximately 5 minutes. As it states, the process can take several hours. However, once it's done, it is done. So I'm going to go ahead and continue by entering in Y and then pressing enter. And I will shorten the sequence of this, although the full sequence will be posted in another video. Now that the upgrade to Ubuntu 18.04 has completed, we'll log back in, and as you see on the login screen, it actually mentions that this is the 18.04 version. So you log in with your same credentials that you used before. And once you do get logged back into the system, you'll want to run sudo apt-get update sudo apt-get upgrade with dash y at the end. And I know you're thinking, why am I upgrading the system when I just installed the latest version of the OS? That's because a lot of times when they package the OS, that the latest version of the packages are not included in that latest release code version. So after you do the installation of the operating system, you'll need to make sure you go back to get those package updates as well that have been released since the latest version of the operating system. And as you see, it's prompting that I have a package that is no longer needed. And so I can remove that as well. So I can use sudo apt-get autoremove. I'll use the purge option. And then I'll use php console-table. And I don't use dash y on this one, as sometimes when you remove one package, it will have a bunch of dependencies that will also be removed. And if you use the dash y option, it will remove those without prompting. Since this is the only package that is going to remove, I'll go ahead and continue. All right, next I'm going to go to my Etsy directory. And since I have the configuration management maintained on this particular server, I'm going to run git status on here. And since the Etsy directory is owned by root, I have to use the sudo command in front of git status. And so it says it's update with the latest version. However, I'm not fully sure about that. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to the root user by using sudo su. And then I'll run git status again. And it says it is updated with the latest version. So I will do git add and then period. And that will add any new files in here. It will also add any existing files. Then I will run git status. And there are no new files. This completes the upgrade to Ubuntu 18.04. And if you want to do one more confirmation, you can do lsb release dash a. You can see here that the release is 18.04 with the code name of Bionic. If this tutorial has helped you, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about anything in this video, please drop them in the comment section below. Also, please follow me on Instagram and Twitter at almostengr.
Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Also, if you would like instant notifications, click the bell.